planning table, I will run the consistency check for our planning area. Go to the MSDP admin and select our planning area ZAPO1. Right click and go to the display mode and go to the extras, select consistency check and set to the time series. So here we need to give the version. This is the active version we are using, and the log, it will provide the log after completed the consistency check. And repair any inconsistency, the system automatically will repair it. And the log, if any logs are there in the system, it will show the log, and it will check the live cache anchor. It will check the database connection between the planning area and the live cache. So everything is green. Now we can go to the interactive planning table. SAP menu.
So we're just checking whether whatever data we created is right.
Yes. There is no inconsistency. Now go to the SAP menu, APO, demand planning, and interactive planning board.
Okay.
Like this is the important screen, and all the business users, 90% of the time is spending in this screen only. Like all the planning activities, they can do here only. So from the user point of user's perspective, this is the important screen. And whatever they told the issues also, basically first we need to see here only. Like the data is really not appearing. Like for example, they told we are running the statistical forecast, but we are not able to see the statistical forecast data. Or like the history is not loaded, and I am entering some values, it is not calculating, it's a macro is not calculating, like that. So basically all the issues, basically the first look we will see here only. So that is the important of this screen. And here we can go to the, like I will first explain what is this details on. Here the macros, like the macros will be will cover into the next session. Basically those are like for the calculation purpose. Anyway, I will detailly explain what is the macros, why the macros, and what exactly macros are doing. But basically, it is a calculation purpose. So, if you create any macros, so those will be appear here. Whatever the macros is belongs to particular this data view, so those we can able to see here. As of now, we have not created any macros, so we are not able to see here. And then here you can see the planning book and data view. Whatever the planning books and the data views are available in the system. So all the planning books and data views you can able to see here. So we can double click here so that it will appear our planning book, our data view. And this is the planning book. And if you double click this planning book, it will give all the details here. Like what is the name, which planning area it is available, what is the planning bucket, what is the live cache, what is the basic unit of measure, what is the MPAS is there. So in the campus, what are the characteristics are there? Like all the details relevant to this planning book, we can see here. And here, like you can see the univariant and all these items. And if you here, like this is the selection profile. In the selection profile, I will tell you. And this is the key figures. What are the key figures we are using in the data view? So now go to the selection window. I will select as a product C. Show product, and I will take as a product, and I will take as a location, and I will save as a product location. Just I'm giving one name, and save it, and go to the continue, and now double click here in the selection profile. So whatever we have created the selection ID, it will show here, drag and drop here. So if you continue here, what is the use of this one, I will explain you. I will come out. Now I will go to the interactive planning. So earlier, to see the product, I have selected this option. Like I want to load the data, I have go to here. But now, like it's the repeating 10 times in the day, like a daily, every time you need to go select a product, instead of that one, whatever we have saved, if you double click here, automatically it will take the selection profile, whatever we are using the selection profile. So here whatever we have selected all the products. So all the products means like a, in the system, like a, in the CVCs we have created a products like a P1, P2, P3. So you can see whatever the products are available under your MPAS.
Okay.
So that you can see all the products. If I select a location, whatever the locations are there, we can see all the locations. We have created only L1 as a location. So I will see location. So like that, for example, there is a 100 products are there. So one user is working on 30 products and another user is working on 30 products and another user working on 40 products. And in the 30 products also, they will work like 10 products one and 10 products one and 10 products one. So that then we can create a 3 selection IDs for one user. So that instead of again selecting 10 products, just they will double click the selection ID. So all the products will be come to here.
Okay.
I can select all and I can go to this option, load data. Then this will be like enable. Earlier it is disabled, like now it is loading the data. It means product 1, product 2, product 3. For these 3 products, what is the sales order? Like for example, 11th month is 100 sales order for product 1, product 2, product 3. What is the forecast? What is the promotion value for this product? If I select only product 1, 34. I have given for 3 products is 100. So equally it is distributing for one product. Now I have selected only one product only. If I want to select 2 products, I can select as 2 products also. Like 2 products I will select and I will load the data. So like that, whatever the product or whatever the master data you are selected here, the relevant to transaction data see here.
Okay.
So now what I will do, I will select all the products, I will load the data. Now we can able to see 100.
Okay.
And what we will do, we will give the history values. Like now, normally history we used to get from the info cube to planning area. There is a one program is there, how we are getting a history from the cube to planning area, I will show you later. But still, like what we will do, we will give a manual history. To give a manual history, select the history key figure and select this icon, distribute icon. So always history is till last month. So I am selecting as a month 10. And I will give as a value something 2000. And equal. It means every month this product from 11-2009 to till this month, selling 2000, 2000, 2000, like all these 3 products, you can say.
So
together of this P1, P2, P3 sales is 2000, 2000, 2000 since beginning of the month to end of this bucket. I am saving the data. This is the save option. So every month we are selling 2000. If I run the statistical forecast, we will see how much forecast system will generate. In the univariant profile, we are given history, read from the history key figure and give the forecast values into the forecast key figure. And this is 24 months we can read and give the values for 24 months. So to run the statistical forecast, we have already defined our univariant profile. So just double click on this one. Now we have created one univariant profile. So automatically system by default it will take the same univariant profile and it will give the statistical forecast.
Okay.
But if you have more number of univariant profiles, so it will give a pop-up which model you want to select it. Like we have selected only ZAPO1, for example ZAPO1, 2, 3, like that. If you create more univariant of profile, it will ask you which profile you want to take. So just you can take the radio button so that it will run the particular model. like in the univariate model, what we are taking is, we have taken the model as a, see here, constant model we have selected.
Yeah.
Just 1 minute. So, we have selected a constant model, Sandi?
Yes.
We have selected a constant model. We have selected a constant model, so that is the reason here the forecast results also constant.
Okay.
We have selected a 2000, so every month we are selling a 2000, so obviously the forecast should be 2000. So last 24 months history you can see here, and till 24 months it is generating the forecast. And here you can see the, like a, I told you, like a, first it will create the trend, and it will take, like how it will be create a forecast, it will create a basic value first.
Okay.
Then based on the alpha, beta, gamma, like a trend seasonal values, it will give the weightage. So if I want to give more weightage for the trend, I need to increase the bit alpha beta value.
Okay.
Like that. And here, if you go to the forecast errors, now it will not show any error because this 2000 is the history. Exactly 2000 we are getting the forecast. So there is no error.
Okay.
100%, yes, 100% this forecast is correct. But now what I will do, I will save this one, and again I will change the history and I will create a another forecast, like I will give a different values for the history and I will run another model.
Kalin, but like we in between we entered like sales order 100, so that will not affect anything?
No, that will not affect anything. Like here, okay, only it is reading the history key figure and it is generating a forecast for the forecast key figure. So remaining key figures,
like sales order or anything,
no. Remaining key figures will not impact anything here.
Okay.
In the master forecast profile, we are giving the study key figure and forecast key figure. Only these two key figures only will impact now.
Okay.
And here you can see the ex post forecast. As I told, the system will first run the forecast for the previous month. So it will run the previous month based on this history, so that it will compare, okay, if history is like this, forecast should be like this. So it will give the forecast for the future like this. So based on this, there is no error in the forecast.
Okay.
And I will save this one and go back to the same screen. You can select this one. If you select this one, it will completely exit. So now, in the interactive planning, you can see this is the history and this is the forecast.
Okay.
Like that, system will generate the forecast. And I have loaded the data, particular the selection ID, and I ran the statistical forecast. So that this forecast will be impact only for this selection. Might be in the system, we have another selections like a P4, P5, P6, that will not impact anything. Because here we are loaded only for these three products only. And here there is a lot of options are there. Say for example, I want to see only these two key figures. I don't want to see all the key figures. Then go to this option, key figure selection. Go to this multiple key figures. And deselect all. And select only history, forecast. And continue. Now, you can able to see only these two key figures. Like that also, if you want only see particular key figures, you can select like this also.
Yeah.
And here, go to this option, header information. Here, give the product. Continue. And I want to see the detail level of information. So go to the detail level. So that it will give the detail level. Like total is 2000, but P1, P2, P3 having this much value. Like this, we can see the detail level also. Or I want to see only one product. You can select only one product. It will show only one product. Now it is showing only P1. And I want to see the graph. Select it here. Right click here. And go to the graphic. So that table plus graph both I can see. So this is the blue is my history and green is my forecast.
Okay.
In the graphical view also we can see here. If you want to see only graph, you can select this option. It will show only complete graph. And if you don't want the graph, unselect the graph, it will not show any graph now. And if you right click here, and you can take the unit of measure also. Like for example, it is showing PC. If I maintain the master data as a kg also, then we can go for the kg. So that it will appear into the kg. Actually here we have not maintained the unit of measure conversion, but we can maintain unit of measure conversion in the master data, and we can change the conversions also.
Okay.
And now I want to take all the key figures. Again, take all the key figures. And if I give some promotion value here, say for example, I will give some promotion value here. But I want to give a message to the, like might be, in the new data sheet. I will give some promotion values here. I will give some promotion value. So I want to give a note to others. Okay. Why I have added this promotion value, I want to give some note. So go to the display note. See like Excel how we are maintaining the comment. Like that we can give here. Something like that. You can give some message. And save it. Like for example, for December we have the Christmas, so we will expect more sales. So I have added the more promotional values. Like that, we can give a message.
Yeah.
It will appear as an icon. So if you right click here, go to the display note. You can see the note.
Okay.
And added since the Christmas, we will expect more sales. Like that, we can give some messages. And if you want to delete it, we can delete it also. Like that, here you can see lot of features are there. And another option now, I want to see this total, like for these three total. Right click, select those three. Right click and select it, you can see the total. So here you can see the total of these three. and we can take the average. We can like that. We can see the calculation also here only. Mean value, maximum value, minimum value, like that. We can see the values also here. And now what I will do, I will select all. I will load the data, and I will give a different history.
Okay.
And we will see, we will run the different models. So I will start from 2000, 2150. Like always, history might be not like equal like a 2000. So sometimes like it is like a, it's like that, 2000, 2150, 2220. Like that, we will give a different value. Now I have given a different history. I will save and I will run the statistical forecast. Earlier the values are like a 2000, 2000, 2000. Now it is overwritten by latest history value. Now we can see 4000, 499, 4099. Like I have selected here the constant model. So my forecast also showing as a constant now. And you can see the forecast errors now. It will appear the forecast errors now. Like here, the 10%.
So it will take average of all of them and then it will.
So here, it is like a 10% is the errors are there. So I can go to the model and I will select the different model. Like I will select the linear regression and I will run again. So now the values will be changing, like 4890, 5009, 5129, 5248, like that. So now we can see the forecast error.
Okay.
So here 0.75 only. Earlier it is 10%, now 0.75. So that I can save this up, save this model. Like that we can select a different model and we can see how much percentage it is showing the difference. Like that automated model, if you are not able to find any model, you can choose the automated model, one or two. Trend model, linear regression, seasonal plus linear regression, like that we can select any model. Like history means, like how exactly the history, the forecast will also be same thing, like it will be copy paste.
Okay.
So now,
like what are the values in red color?
What is that?
There are values in red color.
Again, I will go to that screen. Just I want to show the off now. Again, I will go to the same screen. First, I will show the graph and I will go to the same screen again. Forecast history. Now, if you go to the graph, you can see the graph. So, like that, they will understand, okay, my graph is like this. So, history. Forecast graph also, see. It is similar to this graph. Yes or no? It is graph is going like this. And the forecast graph also going same thing like this. So, like here, like almost my forecast is correct.
Yeah.
Like that, the users, they can see like this. And now, I will select all the key figures. and I will go to the again interact to the univariant. Yeah, tell me now.
No, like in the previous screen, near history values, there were few of them interact. Like just scroll to.
Okay. Actually, that will be like a corrected history values. Like here.
Okay.
Like system automatically will correct it. Like I told you, know, like like spikes are there based on the sigma value. Sigma value, it will correct it. It will correct it, and based on that, it will run the exposed forecast, and it will compare these results, and it will give the final forecast. That is the reason it will get it the maximum, almost correct forecast values.
Okay.
I think again this model is changed here. So again I will take the linear. And if I run automatic, we will see how much errors it will give now. Yeah, these are the corrected history. System automatically will correct it, these things.
Okay.
So now here you can see 1.35, the error percentage. Now we will run a different model. We will run the different model, like a seasonal plus linear regression. This is 8%, it is giving the error. So like that, we can run the different models, and we can select the best model. I run the trend model. So 1.35, this is also okay, trend also good. So here we can say either linear or trend. So seasonal, linear or trend will work for this model.
Multiple forecasts and see whichever has
greater than we correct. Yes, exactly. We will fix that one, and these will be we will assign into the background job so that every month the fixed model will run.
Okay.
Like anyway, these are the like one-time jobs only. Like once in the like concentration time before go live, we will do all these activities so that continuously in the support we will run the same models. And here still we have the different options are there. I will explain those options also. And for example, here the month, it is showing into the month. So I want to see for weeks. So select this one. Go to the storage bucket profiles. Here it will show the bucket profiles like whatever we have created in the earlier, like in the TR30. So it will show all the values. So from here also we can select how we want to see.
Okay.
So we have created VAP. I have created one text that I want to show.
We created four weeks.
Four weeks we have created, and another one I have created for text also, like a combination of month and week. Okay, otherwise I can select the 10 weeks. So it will show only 10 weeks now. See, now it is showing the 10 weeks. And automatically, the data also distributing to weeks, all the weeks. Like for example, in the month, it is a 25 is there. So it will distribute 5555 each week. So how it is distributing is, that is only the aggregation and the disaggregation. If you go to the planning area, here we have the aggregation, like what are the sales orders, we told like a proportionally disaggregate. It means like it will go the proportionally, like based on this aggregation value only it is disaggregating. Anyway, proportional factors time I will take more on this thing so that it will you will get more idea also. And other than this here, what is the options, like I want to save this one as a locally, I can save it. By selecting this option, I can save it as a .csv file, .csv.
Okay.
Like we can save into the local also.
Okay.
We can save as a local file. this is a local site.
Yeah.
Like that, you can see everything. What are the planning book data? And the same structure we can see here, like Excel file.
Yeah.
And here, if you do some changes, and you can save this file, and you can use this button, and you can get it into the from here, upload the data.
Okay.
And it will support the copy paste options also. Say for example, I will copy, and I can paste also. Control V. See, it will support the copy paste options also from Excel to here. And this is the header user manual setting. User setting. For example, I don't want to give some key figures to some users. Say for example,
okay.
I don't want to allow one user to give the promotional values. So just hide it. Here hide option is there. Hide it and save and exit. And refresh it now. You will not able to see here the promotion key figure. Now you will not able to see any promotion key figure here.
Yeah.
So like that, for some users, if you don't want to give some option, we can hide here.
Okay.
And for example, I will again go to the 24 month. And again, after running the statistical forecast, see, I am easily can edit it. So actually, it's not really, it should not happen. We should not, somebody should not like edit, like then we don't know like what system is giving, what they're editing, like that. So to control this one, go to the design. Right click. And select a row and give output only.
Okay. So only the planner can only do that, right? Only planner can.
No. Actually, we can restrict these things. For example, the system generated forecast and go to the live. It will take you back. So the system generated values, we don't want to overwritten by others.
Okay.
So that will be disabled. Like it will not allow to now enter any value here.
Okay.
So like that, if some key figures, like for example sales orders always we are getting from the history, we should not overwrite the sales order value. So those we can restrict like this, and total forecast and statistical forecast, which are the key figures is not allowed to overwritten, we can fix the key figures.
Okay.
So now, did you get the clear idea? Like what are the master data we are collecting when we are running the statistical forecast?
If you're getting data from ECC, will it be populated over here, right? It will be like, if you're getting sales or the same from ECC, it will be populated, right?
Yeah, actually, from ECC to, we will take into the one cube. And from cube 2, we will get the planning area. Yeah, that is the program, like load from the info cube. By using this program, we can populate the values. Say for example, here we are giving the info cube and the version, planning area, version. From when to when, the date, and in the key figures, we can give from history key figure from the info cube to planning area, history key figure. So that it will copy the data from there to here, like R3 to info cube to planning area, so that the values will be appear here. Yes.
We can like load multiple amount of times. If you want to change once, we can also change, like go there and we can change the amount of load we are taking from the decoder.
Yeah, normally this is what we are doing, like this is also we are fixing and we are running in the background. Like every month it will run the 3 months of history, 3 months of sales orders, like that.
Okay, yeah.
Anyway, that I will cover in the background. background jobs time and the process change time.
Yes, okay.
And now we have generated the forecast and we will give some promotion, and in the consensus meeting they will give the some manual correction so that these three will add as a total forecast. So
okay.
to add as a total forecast, we have to create a macro. So macro will calculate automatically what are the values are there here plus here plus here is equal to as a total forecast. For that reason we are creating a macro. So almost these are the features of the planning, interactive planning screen. So if you like anyway, daily we used to use this screen only, like whatever activities we are doing, like a life cycle planning, we are doing the configuration and we will see the results here. Like that macros we will create and we will see the results here. Like that everything we will see the results only here only. So that it will be like a daily we will run the same screen so that you will have the more idea on this one. It will be repeated the activity. So as of now, all these are clear, Sandeep?
Yeah, this is clear, Kalyan.
Okay.
If I have any questions, I will start tomorrow.
If you are able to create, you can create. Otherwise, if you are not able to create, at least you can use this GAP one, you can practice. At least one, just one cycle, you can complete it.
I'll try and run the whole cycle tomorrow.
If not possible, at least you can use the same planning books and same database and you can try to run one cycle.
Okay.
So that's it. And I will share all the documents, like each and every field about the information, like all what exactly this will do, what exactly this cycles. That is one document I will give. And one document I will give, what is the formula for the statistical forecast and forecast error. That document also I will provide you. And I will provide you the MLR forecast, that is also step-by-step process I will provide you. After this class, I will send those documents to you.
In the company, we will not define any forecast model. Normally, the system will choose maximum, whatever the SAP is provided, those are enough, maximum. Okay,
Sandeep. Again, we will meet tomorrow, 6:30 morning India time.
Thanks,
Sandeep. Thank you. Bye.